Welcome back to the channel, everybody. I'm Trevor with Maker Experiment, and in today's video, we are going to be covering how to use a rotary attachment on the LogoJET UV printer. Let's get into it. First up, I'm going to show you how to set up the rotary attachment on the printer, so let's head over there. If you watched one of my past videos, you saw me put these attachments on for the rotary. So all we need to do on this is shift them over to where the magnet overhangs the bed and then use the screw to hold it in place, just like that. There is one on both sides, so make sure you do it to the other one as well. And in a second, I'll show you what this is for. Next, in order to allow for the rotary to fit, I'm going to lower the bed. I would just go ahead and lower it pretty much the entire way down. The way that this works is as the table moves forward and backward, it will rotate the cup because the wheels are rotating with the bed. This is going to be how the cup actually rotates while printing. As far as the setup goes, you want to make sure that these wheels, front to back, all line up with each other. Make sure that they're all even. And depending on the cup, that's going to be where you want to land them. So for example, on this one, I'm going to want a set of wheels near the front, probably another near the middle, and then the last one I'll put right about here. Once you have them lined up here, I then go to the back and just make sure that they're lined up there as well. An important part of the rotary attachment is that there's a slot here and their slot here. You can move these bars in and out. So if you have something narrow, you'll want them on the inside. If you have something that has a larger diameter, you're going to want them on the outside. Do not mix and match. You do not want one in and one out. You either want both in or both out. When it comes to the rotary, we have these black pieces that you can stick up and slide along. These are your stops. So near the front, I'm going to place a stop that I will place the rim of the cup against. Now you can see over here, it can just move freely. I don't have anything holding it in place. That is where this bar comes in. As you're setting this up, you'll see the holes along the edge. There are pins in this bracket that align with the holes in that frame. So you want to make sure that you fit into the hole. And then once you do, go ahead and tighten it down. Then we can fine tune adjust where the stop is with the cup. The next thing we want to check is if the cup is level. So here, it's not quite as level as I'd like it to be. To adjust the level, you can undo this knob on the left and then raise and lower the wheels over here until it is level. And then once it's level, go ahead and tighten it down. Then we can test if the cup moves freely by moving the bed back and forth. Just make sure that it doesn't hang up anywhere and that you see it rotate with no problem. And that's all there is to the setup of the rotary with the cup. One of the biggest concerns that I get when someone is printing on a material where maybe they only have one of that material is, how can I make sure that I get this done right the first time so that I don't throw away a $10, $15, $20 item? My answer to this is painter's tape. If you have not done this before, what I do is I take the painter's tape, like so, and I will wrap in line with the rim around the cup, like so. So what we'll do is we're going to put this back on the printer. I'm going to make sure it moves freely still, because with that additional friction from the tape and kind of the bumps, it may have made a little bit of an issue. But typically, if I'm doing something and I want to make sure it's done right the first time, I will go ahead and test it this way print my design, make sure that it looks okay before I ever peel off the tape and then go ahead and print the real thing. So that's what we're gonna do here. Now let's set up the artwork. In order to set up the design, we need to measure the cup. So I use a fabric ruler, and what I'm going to do is run it along the circumference of the cup and get that measurement, which is about 11 inches. And then the other thing I want to do is measure how high or how tall I want the logo to be. So the cup itself is about 6 3/4, which is probably gonna be difficult to see. I don't want the logo or this design to take up that entire thing. I only want it to take up maybe, I'll call it 2.5 inches or so, which is about here to here. This is all up to personal preference on how much you want it to cover, but that is what I'm going to go with. I'm gonna go with that 2.5. So the other thing is where you want it height wise. So even though I want it to be 2.5, I want to make sure that it's somewhat centered on the cup. From the rim to the ridges is about 5 inches. So I'm going to try to center it in the middle of those two. So I'm going to walk you through everything that I do here with the design, but you're going to need to be able to measure all of those elements in order to get the look that you're going for. So here with my design, I want it to be 2.5 inches tall. So what I'm gonna do is go into the height and change that. The other thing to keep in mind with designs like this, with rotary, just kind of like with the laser, is you want to probably skew the width about 10%. So I'm gonna go in here and unlink the width, and I'm gonna say times 1.1. And this will stretch it just a little bit so that as it rotates, it doesn't squish back together. So I do this for all of my laser stuff as well to make sure that it doesn't kind of scrunch it together. Next, I'm going to turn on my rulers. So first I want to mark where the edge of the cup is going to be, or the top of the cup, because this does not line up exactly with the edge of the bed when it's on the rotary attachment. So in my case, I just measured it from how far it sticks out, and it's about 1.75 to the top of the cup from the edge of the bed. Next, I want to make another guide that's the bottom of the silver rim, which is 9/16, 1.75. You can type it in as a formula and it will add it for you. So this is the bottom of the silver rim. And what I'm going to do next is I'm going to set up another guide for the middle of the artwork. I'm going to start with the same location as the bottom of the silver rim, and then just add the extra 2.25 inches to get to the end of the cup. I have the top of the cup is the first line, the bottom of the silver rim is the second line. The third guide is where I want it to land on the cup, and then the fourth line is the bottom of the cup. The reason why it's shifted toward the top is because there's ridges at the bottom of this cup that I want to avoid. So I'm centering it as best I can between the ridges and that silver rim. This is why I have so many lines and guides on my artwork. The next thing I want to do is rotate my artwork 90 degrees. Keep in mind that my cup is going to sit with the rim toward the left-hand side of the artboard. So I'm just going to drag it up here, and then I'm just going to line them up so that the artwork is centered on that line. As far as rotationally, there's no print on this. So I could, in theory, have this all the way at the top. I could have it further down. And if I wanted to try to be aligned with the center, the circumference of the cup was 11 inches. So I can put a guide basically halfway, which would be that 11 divided by 2, which will be 5.5. And I could snap it to the center. If you have artwork with a logo on it, this is probably the way you want to do it. For me, I don't have a logo on this cup, so I'm just going to leave it where it is so that it can just get to that spot of the cup a lot faster. Now I'm going to save this as an artwork. I'm going to go over to my print software. I'm going to open up that design, and here is the design. You can do all of this in the print software. I just prefer to do everything in Illustrator because it's easier for me. but there is a way to do it through the print software directly. Here, I'm going to make sure that I choose my rotary print environment. So I'm going to choose the white plus color, go to my print setup, go under properties, and underneath of device options, I'm going to look at the layers to use. With the smaller the item, the more layers you want to use. Given that this is a tumbler, you could probably get by with 4 or 6. I'm going to do 6. Go over to my layer selection and you will see 6 different bars on it. You want your artwork or your print to be in the middle, and you'll see your selection is not on centered channels. So what I want to do is take my artwork and change it over to those centered channels. You'll get the little green check that says you're good to go. So here I'm going to click OK. I'm going to click OK again. Now this is a great time to check and see if it prints right the first time. So painter's tape is on. We'll see if it prints correctly, because inevitably, without enough coffee, I always mess this up. Hence the design. So let's put this on the printer and then we will go check out how it turns out. Okay, as we set this up, we want to bring the carriage head out. Make sure that the cup is all the way down. And then what we want to do is slowly raise the bed. And what you should be looking for is a small gap between the print head and the tumbler, like so. You want to make sure that it doesn't collide with the tumbler itself. So here is the overall result. I do like it. It lands about where I want it to. So what I'm gonna do is go ahead and peel off the painter's tape. Coolest part about painter's tape is once you peel it off, it is like it never happened. So this allows you to test pretty much any item you want without fear of it getting ruined. All right, now for the real thing. I will say that before you print onto metal surfaces like this, make sure that you're using an adhesion promoter, preferably one that is meant for metal adhesion. Now, the cool part is, say I put this cup down here to the left, I can just take another one, put it right here, hit print, and it'll print out exactly the same way because I have this stop set up for the rim and this set up for the height. So if you're doing production runs of say 100 of these or so, having it set up and getting it done right the first time and dialing everything in makes it very repeatable for a production level set. Another thing that you can do that is very helpful in these situations is down at the bottom where your print job is, you can hit the plus sign, and then underneath of it, you can see that the ink cost for this project was 5 cents. So it is relatively cheap to do this process. So even though I did a test run and made sure that everything ran in place and made sure everything was aligned, it still only cost me maybe 10 to 15 cents of ink to do that process. So don't be afraid to check and make sure that everything works before you just go and print it. So you've seen me print on the 20-ounce black tumbler. Right after that, I set up the machine and printed on a white 30-ounce tumbler. They're not just for tumblers. You can also use the rotary to print on cylindrical items like the flour and sugar containers that you use for your kitchen. There are a lot of opportunities for using the rotary attachment. Tumblers just happen to be the most popular thing because a lot of people carry them around every day. If you're looking for a solution to print onto cylindrical items, the LogoJET UV printer rotary attachment is a great way to do that. I do want to give a huge shout out to LogoJET, who is the sponsor of this video. I've been using LogoJET UV printers for a couple of years now, and just recently got the UVX 45i late last year, and I love it. It makes adding color to my designs so much easier. I've used it for a combination of laser and UV printing. I've used it for UV printing only. If you do own a laser and you are looking to add color to some of your work, I would highly suggest looking into UV printers. They will allow you to unlock some creative things that I never could have done without it. If you're interested in learning more about LogoJET printers, I will put a link in the description below. You can also go to logojet.com. If you decide to request a sample to see what their machines are capable of, make sure to tell them that Maker Experiment sent you. And if you have any questions along the way, feel free to reach out and I will do my best to answer any of the questions that you have. That's going to do it for this video. Hopefully you found it helpful. If you did, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and turn on notifications so that you know when I come out with new videos. If you have any questions about the process or what I do, put them in the comments below and I will do my best to answer those. Be sure to check out LogoJET on all of their social media channels as well as at logojet.com. And be sure to check out my socials at Maker Experiment. But I want to thank you for taking the time to watch this video, and I will see you in the next one.